Greetings, sir and sirettes, and welcome back to Ark Survival Evolved with me, Lathrix. And of course, welcome to our new home on the island we discovered in the previous episode, the one exceedingly close to Carnivore Island and the giant volcanoes. In today's episode, we are going to be setting up our base here. Although I have already done most of the legwork, it's almost complete, other than one of the more fun elements which we're going to be working on today, and I'm going to hope to explore some of the top section of this island, as I've mostly just explored the beaches since getting here. Now, originally, I was going to build a very small base down here, and then simply have ladders going all the way up to the top of this arc. Now, this is still going to be my main goal, but I've had to start putting up some walls, because two things happened. Number one, raptors absolutely everywhere, and then number two, a fearsome animal got into the main area and actually killed multiple of my dinosaurs. I've lost my scorpion, I've lost a handful of dodos, I lost one of my diplos, I lost the small monkey, and I think I lost the headbutting dinosaur as well. But in return, we did tame this fearsome beast, and her name is Fluffy. Fluffy the level 62 bear, which just pooped, which I have to say was an absolute nightmare to tame. It took like 20 trank arrows and I almost killed the thing. It seems like their health isn't actually as extreme as I thought it was, but they have loads of torpor. I have no idea how I didn't kill this thing. But because of this, and the fact I've seen several bears after this, well, I think better safe than sorry, let's build a little fortification down here. So what I'm going to do is go away and continue to deforest this entire area of beach, build up the wall too high because it just looks better than a single one high wall, try and figure out how I'm going to do a bit of a dock just to make sure animals can actually not get in by simply swimming around, and then we can start building ladders all the way to the top here. Now, I do currently have two pteranodons, I forgot the name there, one called Banshee in remembrance of our old Banshee from the previous season, and I do have the original pteranodon, so I could just fly up there, but I would rather have the ability to climb up if necessary. That, and it's just a really cool concept. On the upside, turns out the bear is a really, really good mount. Not only does it hold a ridiculous amount of inventory, look how much weight this thing can hold. No, that's me. There we are, weight 741, which I haven't upgraded at all, but it actually makes an absolutely fantastic berry harvester. It doesn't harvest as much as other animals per bush, and it doesn't have the most AoE attack, but you can harvest whilst running, and it runs exceedingly quickly, and gets faster the longer you run without hitting something, like I did just there. Let's pretend that was on purpose to demonstrate a point. Oh, it also hits like an absolute truck as well, hence why it killed almost all of my animals. Level 5 trike. And it's dead. As you can see, it's not exactly weak at all, so at least now I have a true combat mount. So, with all of that out of the way, I'm going to be right back, and as soon as this wall is finished and I have some more ideas, we can get to designing our new ladder system. Also, I realise I think I just called this arc rather than an arch. Well, I mean, it is an arc shape, so that kind of works as well, and we are on the arc, so arc. I can see a raptor just around the corner. Now, I'm fairly certain the bear will absolutely destroy the raptor, but even so, I think we need to do a little bit of science. Hello. And goodbye, level 40 raptor. Ooh, there's one over there as well. At least this will get me some good experience. Oh no, it's killing compies, and I'm gonna have to kill them as well, because all my attacks are AoE. Well, at least it was pretty darn easy. Still not sure which attack's better, the right click, which does more damage but drains more stamina, or the faster left click. Actually, is it even that faster? Okay, so it seems like right click is just more damage. Well, that's fairly useful to know. And I've been completely distracted by the whole let's build things, and I'm now looking down the beach, because we're incredibly fast now. Just don't hit anything. Oh, Dodo. Goodbye, Dodo. Oh, I love this bear. Who's made you the fluffy? You're made you the fluffy. Ooh, a Bronto. Can a bear kill a Bronto? First of all, increase damage, because why not? But seriously though, would a bear actually be able to kill a Bronto? I remember the last time I played Ark before this season, I did kill a Bronto using a high level raptor, so level 9 isn't too high. Okay, we're going for it. Knocked me away, but thankfully I can attack on the move, except for with the right click. Because screw this leg in particular. The rest can live, this one will die. Oh, it seems like, wow, that was absolutely no challenge at all. Come on, just perish already. You're horribly bleeding, you must be in so much pain. There we go. Ow, we are being attacked by a trike though. Wow, that was a good hit there, bear. Didn't know you were so strong, but saying that, you did just kill a Bronto. Ooh, we just killed a Bronto. Prime meat. Which means if we can find a compy, we could actually, not a compy, is it compy, the little guys, the smallest ones? They need prime meat, and that's the only reason why we haven't tamed one already. So if we can find one quickly, before the body starts to decay, then lure it over there, we could quickly tame it. This has got so distracted from my original intentions for the episode. Also, I'm currently poisoned. Dodo, dodo, trees, stone, that's not an animal, egg collector, headbutty dinosaur, raptor, other egg collector dinosaur, or perhaps that was the same one, more dodos, no, I can't see any nearby, and I don't really want to spend all day looking for one, which is a shame, honestly, because prime meat doesn't last very long, even if it's in the animal's inventory. Dodo, dodo, dodo. Did one of those just survive an attack? Wow, hardy dodo. I'll be accepting that, thank you. Well, I'll run back, and if I find a compy, then so be it, we'll try and tame one. If not, then I'll just go back to building the wall. I can see a compy. Now you, stay still, and perhaps kill the Dilo attacking you. I'm going to ignore that, and I'm going to try and tame this little guy. Hello. Now I could use the crossbow. The crossbow does give more trank effect, but I feel like the crossbow would kill this thing. Boop. There we go. Now I know these things have really fast torpor bars, so spam use that. Yes, I know it's wasting it, but the effect, well, the duration does somewhat stack. Because I'm going to need to run all the way to you. Hello, bear, but I'll take the prime meat, thank you very much. Just grab everything I can, run back. Why are you so annoying, little animals? You are hard to tame, you randomly bite things, you're just annoying all round. There we go, we have a compy. Ignoring that coughing fit. Okay, so here we are, let's try and read this again. I probably just cut that because that was absolutely dreadful. One of the smallest predators on the island, they can be seen as a pet, a pest, or a danger. Whilst alone, they are not aggressive. In larger packs, however, it remembers that it's a carnivore, which just sounds so darn adorable. Many children find them adorable, so some tribes still tame them. One positive trait is that their distress call carries further than most other dinos, alerting the tribe to danger more efficiently. So there we are, we have our own little dino. Oh, I didn't know you could pick them up! Yay, we have a new shoulder-mounted animal! Oh, who's a whittle annoyance? Yes, you are. Maybe that's what I'll call you, annoyance. Tripping over my words mentally the last few days. Annoyance. There we are. You can be equipped like a new backpack. Little Fluffy here can now be my mount again, and we'll set off. I'm guessing the prime meat is now spoilt, though. No, it hasn't, and there was a second compy over here somewhere. Oh, I think the Dilo may have killed it. Well, there was a second. Back to building. I just realised I didn't show off the dossier for our little dire bear, so here it is. There we go, if you'd like to read it, feel free to pause the screen now. the wall is pretty much complete, so now we can figure out exactly where we're going to be building. Of course, the problem is, building from the bottom, then building upwards, there's a good chance we'll build in the wrong place. So, rather to be safe than sorry, let's get on our little pteranodon, figure out where we're going to build. Let's say here, since this is quite a nice flat surface at the end. Not the best at the top, but let's ignore that. So now we just fall directly down, if we can. So somewhere like here. Land. Should be about right. Although it did move a little bit forward at the end, so perhaps like there. Now that should be okay. Definitely looks it. So now we can start building. I have got a lot of stuff currently being held by Banshee, since we had far too much stuff to fly a second ago. You're kind of in the way, but now you're too heavy to actually move. There we go. Well done. And so we just build upwards. Afterwards, we can enclose it and make it look a bit nicer, but for now, I would just like to build directly upwards, and I'm really hoping this is in the right place. We'll find out when we get to the top, I suppose. And back to deforesting the area, destroying all of the trees. I am remarkably tired right now. There were so many trees over here at one point. Now there isn't. I am really confused right now. Do the thing you were just doing a second ago. Yeah, that. I assumed at a distance these two were just Brontos. Then when I got closer to one, it started nudging me. It's apparently doing no damage. I don't know if this is a territory thing or what. It's almost cute. It looks like a rather drugged up Bronto, honestly. So I'm assuming it's a sauropod. You're a level one. What are you? Honestly, I have no idea what these are. Diplo. I will call them Diplos because that's an easy way to say it, even though I'm sure it's not pronounced like that in the full name. They're just bouncing me around. Do they do the same to me? You're going to drown my bear. What's with this? Why are you doing this, you weird creatures? Nope, I'm leaving you. You are bizarre. I'm assuming they're tameable. Are they meant to be friendly? I don't get that. Is it a friendly... Did anyone else just see the two parasaurs fall from the sky? Anyway, are they supposed to be friendly, or is that like a territory thing? Okay, I want to find out. If they are friendly... Well, it depends what level of friendly, because there's so many passive tames now. Are they tameable in a passive way, or is it a knocking out kind of friendly? A knocking out kind of friendly. Oop. Well, better eat some of the berries. I was just about to try and feed you guys. Because I have no meat on me, apparently, because I forgot to cook things. Excuse me. Excuse me, sir. I think you was a sir. Sir? Hello? Oh my god, they're actually passive tames. I so thought that was going to fail. No, let me feed you! Let me feed you, please! Got ya! That was surprisingly effective. You seem quite easy to tame. Now what's your name again? I want to search it in the thing. Diplo, Diplo, Diplo. Okay, just keep on knocking me around then. Dip. It has 10 seats. Yeah, but can you be used to harvest berries, though? That's the question, even if you are really bizarre. Where's my bear gone? Wherever you are, follow me if you can. Well, I know what I'm doing now for the next while. I need to go somewhere where, when it bounces me, there we go, like this. So it bounces me and I don't move. You are sodding bizarre. Well, I'll be back soon, because this is going to be really easy, just take a very long time. Oh, this looks so wrong. Please stop. Please. No more. This this is taking way too long. It's been 15 minutes now and I've only fed it twice. So, I looked it up on the wiki. I normally don't like doing that until I actually have the dossier myself, but considering it was taking so darn long, I thought I would anyway. And it turns out, very mercifully, you can actually knock these out as well. It doesn't seem to be all that difficult. So, I'm going to go in quickly, or at least as fast as I possibly can, go back to my lovely drug corner, now that we're armed with lots and lots of narco berries, and we already have loads of spoiled meat in there, and we can make ourselves a load of trank arrows. We're going to drug it up and make it our friend. This is such a weird day today. So, narcotics, we need more spoiled meat, we have more on other animals, so I'll go and grab those as well. Away from our drug corner for a second. Bear, good, you're not moving. The dodo won't have meat on it, but who will? Oh, the raptor will. Raptor, do you have meat? Yes, you do, and you have loads of spoiled meat as well. Oh, good, I'm starving. Well, I can cook things at least. Nom 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 nom. Also, it seems like if I wanted to hand feed that thing, I really needed some kibble. And since I haven't got the ability to actually make kibble at the moment, that would be a bit hard to do. That should be enough. 24, since it's quite a low level, then we just need to make some arrows, then some trank arrows, then we can try again. Crossbows aren't good enough health, I think. Which is good, because honestly, I have no way of repairing that right now, because I have nowhere near enough metal. Craft all. Ah, there seems to be a raptor attacking things nearby, and I looked it up again just to see its stats, and found out something absolutely amazing. That giant hunk of apparently incredibly friendly flesh can't actually do damage with its attacks, or at least it doesn't seem to be able to, and doesn't even aggro animals when it hits them. On top of this, it doesn't seem to be able to harvest resources. It's completely useless. Are we going to stop though? No, because I am also completely useless, so we are akin. We are bestest friends already. On top of this, it won't even try to run from me when I attack it apparently. So yeah, stupidest animal on Ark, including the dodo there. And you're the level one, okay. Yeah, I know, you're gonna knock me around. Ooh, hitting your head's gonna be difficult if you're doing that all the darn time though. See what I mean? You look so scary though! It's like you have the potential to be a really menacing animal, but no, you're like stupidly friendly. That was way too early. Oh, I'm going to waste so many shots. Thankfully I need 20 for an fray level 1. I just heard something aggressive. Did anyone else hear the oh no, it's my animal biting it. God damn it. No. Push me to the side instead. If you keep on pushing me back, I'll end up actually getting hit by something. I have no idea where my bear is. Okay, it's over there. This is a very boring process when the animal doesn't even fight back. It's still trying to be friendly. It's still trying to be friendly as I shoot arrows into its face. Oh, you're like the sweetest thing. You need like a really nice name, like a really, really kind-hearted name. I kind of want to call you George. You're the big friendly giant. You're the BFG. Oh, I could call it BFG. Is that being knocked out? Or no, it's just trying to befriend me again. And another arrow to the sky. This may take a while. Go down already. It may have taken a while, but thankfully we are now finally almost done. Sadly, my hatchet and pickaxe are both about to break, but thankfully, it turns out there's a massive metal reserve right there on top of us, which means all I had to do was just fly up and grab some metal, so we can now mass produce that again, and we also have a load of stone and a load of flint, so we can start making some more gunpowder by making more spark powder. Which is actually very good for my experience bar, so that's fantastic. The gunpowder, though, does need some more charcoal. Did I have any charcoal saved up? It doesn't look like it, but I did have a load of wood in here for some reason. That's helpful if I ever need some more wood. I could go and get some thatch rather than having to get wood and thatch and then just come back here, which is pretty darn good. Also, we did have a load of spoiled meat. We also have ladders, which I do actually need, so maybe should have looked in there first. Might have been a better idea to see what we actually had left in our storage first. And this goes into there, then this goes into here, and then this gets repaired. And then I need one more metal, then I can actually... Sorry, two more metal, then I can repair the hatchet, go back out, get the rest of the stuff we need. Although all we really need to get is a fair bit more thatch than just that, but some thatch. And then we're pretty much all the way to the top. Then we'll need some ceilings to build from there over actually onto the arch itself. And here's hoping we've built close enough, because it is looking a little bit off, honestly. I wonder how many of you just noticed that I didn't actually repair my pickaxe before taking it out of the smithy. I'm guessing way too many of you. A lot of thatch later. We finally have him. I've also learnt the engram for his saddle. There's almost no point, honestly. It's clearly for multiplayer, absolutely useless for single player. But I really feel like we just kind of have to put a saddle on him just to see how it looks. Oh my god, he runs like a dog. You're a puppy. This explains everything. They've put a puppy's mind into a giant sauropod. Or sauropod. Big creature. Well, you can move over here. Of course, you can't actually get through here, so we're going to have to get you through the water somehow. So I guess I'll check up how much your saddle costs and then do it that way. Probably be a lot easier, although I will need some metal. So let's get back. Probably don't have enough metal just yet. We only have like 20 or so ingots. So a quick look-see. So it is built in the smithy. Oops, there is it. Didn't mean to do that. And we want saddles, and there it is, and wow, 200 metal it's going to cost for this. That is just so not worth it in any way. Just, I'm going to do it anyway. I said I was going to do it, so I'm going to do it. It's just an absolute colossal waste of time. Okay, we don't actually need all that many more, so let's build two more of those, one more of those, and then we'll go out and get some more wood and make ourselves ramp and roof. Not the thatch roof, the wood roof, so it's wood. Is it called wooden ceiling? Ceiling, there it is. Which I was spelling wrong. Once again, I am dyslexic, so that's not exactly a surprise. Oh, we need fiber, that's what we're missing. Well, thankfully, the bear has loads of that right now. Since it's a surprisingly good fiber farm, which is a weird thing to say. You have fiber, which I need. So let's actually get up there and see what we do need. I can build on the ladder. Sadly, not quite there yet, so I'm going to have to go back down again, and once I've gone back down, this will definitely be the last time. We only need a couple more sections, and then we're right at the top. For some reason, I thought this was climbable. It's a sheer rock face, so we've made this weird little section here, which only serves to add a point to climb onto, and thus probably kill myself at some stage, because I also need one of the pieces of ceiling with the hole in it, whatever that's actually called. So a quick look-see. Wood. We need hatch frames. We need at least two of them, so that's another thing we need to make. So I'll be right back once all this is done. This was an absolute mess. This was a good lesson, at least, in how the foundations actually work and the limitations around them. I did not understand a lot of stuff going into this, and now I simply do. So, on one hand, I have learned things, which is pretty good. On the other hand, wow, it was so darn annoying. But at least now I can put it all behind me. I have a little ramp all the way down to the bottom, which means if I don't have access to the pteranodon, or simply I want to hold more than a pteranodon can, since it can only hold a little bit, I now have the option to walk, well, climb all the way up myself, rather than relying on that. Yay for this. And look, here is all the metal I was talking about. There's loads of metal over there going all the way back to that little cliff, and there's metal going into the mineland as well. I'm not going to get any closer though, because there's actually several bears at the moment. So I'm going to chip away at this, get myself a grand total of 400 metal, which of course means I'm going to have to make the climb at least twice, and then we can make the huge saddle and call it a day. Next episode, I'll be building a gun, I'll be reinforcing the walls down at the bottom and making some little shooting outposts, and I would like to build a catapult, because apparently a catapult turret is actually something you can build in this game, and that just looks freaking awesome. So, a bit more labor ahead of me, and then we can finally see something cool. Well, it took a very long time, but there we go, enough metal to make the saddle. Let's see what else we're actually going to need then. So saddles, and this, we need fiber, hide, and wood, all of those exceedingly easy to get, even if we do need to go out and get a little bit more hide. Not that much, actually. I had several hundred on one of the animals, and what on earth is following me? Oh, you. Well done, Pteranodon. Yeah, I was using it to go to the top, then just keeping it on follow as I slowly climb back down. But there we are anyway, we have enough metal, we finally are smelting it, so I'll go ahead and get all the other stuff, so then we can finally make the saddle. What I'll need to do, either off camera or in the next episode, is start collecting all the stone I've been throwing away up there, and make a series of forges, so that we can at least smelt things up there, and then of course actually make a smithy, so up there will be our industrial centre. Now, you're not particularly good at actually skinning animals, are you, Bear? I know you're good at getting meat, but I think all your other stats are actually pretty bad. But at the same time, you're ridiculously good at killing things, so you need to stay there, and I'm going to go out and kill animals. Ooh, it's kind of horrible, but there is the other diplo somewhere around, unless it's already been killed, and all I can imagine is that is a lot of hide. And a very easy kill, since it can't actually fight back. Apparently you spawn really often here, so it's not too bad, but sorry, I know I'm killing a gentle giant here, I am the most horrible person in the world, but, you know, a bear's gotta eat. Oh, it's not even fighting back, it's just nudging. I can't do it, that's just so mean! I'll kill less adorable animals. Hello, Parasaur. Sorry, buddy, but you're nowhere near as cute as that other. I mean, look, it's so stupid! In such a cute way. Okay, so that's good. All we need now is 141 more metal ingots, and it's done. We can make the mega saddle and see just how it looks. Sadly, the metal is taking a long time to smelt, however, and this is why we need multiple forges. More forges, faster smelting, everything's better, but at least in the meantime, I can make a load more gunpowder and such, and I can do my ultimate pastime, which of course is making narcotics. The ultimate pastime in the world of Ark. Now, it's very, very dark at the moment, and no, I can't see anything either, it's literally pitch black, but you should have some narco berries on you. And so, I can make a load of narcotics and then go out and get some more narco berries and spend my time wisely in Drug Corner, which is also Gunpowder Corner, so it's drugs and munitions. Because that's a good combination, which is totally safe. This is the result of farming for narcotics for only about 2 minutes. All of this raw meat, all now ready to start rotting and all stacked individually, which of course increases the rate of it rotting exponentially. And we also have loads of narco berries. This bear is the ultimate drug baron. After being AFK for a ludicrous amount of time, all of the meat, other than the ones which were actually still stacked up, have gone rotten, which means we are now making loads of narcotics, and I also managed to finally get enough metal for the saddle. Now, this took a very, very long time. We really need more forges. Only one is just nowhere near enough. It just doesn't serve our purpose at all. Unless, of course, we put them all in and then go out and do loads of other stuff. But since it's now 5:30 a.m. and I have been playing for almost 6 hours straight, I really wasn't in the mood to go out and build again because, well, honestly, I'm falling asleep at this stage. But dedication is dedication. Now a derpy little dino with his derpy little grin can finally have a saddle. Look, he's even leveled up while he's been standing here. There we go. Some purpose to you by adding some more white. The saddle is on, and it looks like that. Oh, cool. So it's like a series of little seats on the side. Oh, wow. Look at that. So 5 on each side, which actually means it's an 11-man saddle because of you as well. I thought it was 11. Sorry, I thought it was 10, including yourself. Wow. Oh, look how derpily he runs. Go on, turn around. Wow, turning circle does not exist here. Oh, he runs like a puppy. He runs like a really, really derpy, broken puppy. Wait. Is he attacking with his mouth or not? No, he's not. Do I have a right click? Do I have a C option? No, nothing. Let's just make sure I was actually correct, though. Let's try to harvest stuff. Harvest. Oh no, you can harvest! You can indeed harvest, very inefficiently, only with the head. How about if I look to the side? Nope, still only with the head. Nudge. And no, it doesn't seem to do any damage, though. Not that slow, though. Runs out of stamina too quickly, but not the slowest of animals. Nudge. Oh, you are so silly. Didn't even need to swim because how big he is, but there we are. One of the silliest animals we have, and no, you can't build on his saddle, sadly. It would be awesome if you could, then he would have some kind of purpose, but apparently not. Wow. Also leveling up because of the extra narcotics we're making. Even more fortitude! There we go, 126 points left. Okay, if I jump onto that bear, I probably won't take damage. Oh, or it's just low enough anyway. Okay then, I honestly thought I was about to take damage. Apparently not. Not quite as high as a Bronto. The last thing I want to check then before we end the episode is just how much is it going to cost to make the catapult turret. Now, I have no idea how we load this weapon. I haven't seen a boulder or any form of rock item in the engrams. I'll have another look just to make sure. It seems like perhaps you just load it with stone, which would be really, really cool. So that'll be some form of perimeter defense. We do need a lot of metal, sadly, but thankfully next episode that'll be dealt with. And with that, thank you so much for watching. If you have enjoyed today's episode, then of course, likes, favorites, shares, comments, all that good stuff helps out me, helps out the channel, and most importantly, shows that Ark Survival Evolved is a series you wish to see continued in the future. Thank you again for watching, and goodbye.